So today, Gordon, we're going to be looking at Knipex's Multicrimp tool. This one I've got here, and I believe it's going to replace the legacy collection you've got over here.
Okay, so you're somehow suggesting this is the Swiss Army knife of crimp tools, Gary?
Well, it certainly takes up less real estate in my toolbox than your three legacy tools. What have you got in front of us?
Okay, well, I've got my traditional insulated crimp tool, had for years, rock solid, copper tube terminal crimper, hardly ever used, that's more your world, and ferrule crimper, which I've had for years, and is built like a tank.
Okay, so first of all, let's have a look at how I'm going to remove the mechanisms that are held within this section here. So I've got the ability to do the same crimps you have here in this section here.
Okay, so that's like a cassette mechanism there, and I would suggest Gary's now going to make it look easy. It wasn't earlier because we hadn't read the instructions. So go on then, Gary, show us how it works.
So what we've got is this bar here. So there is a little bar in the handle itself, and that needs to be put into the upright position when either pulling out or returning the actual crimp mechanism. So that's the first thing. Took a while to work it out.
That is an absolute top tip.
And we've also got a rotate round for the one we're going to go. I'm going to go for the red, the blue, and the yellow crimp that you've got here. Okay. So I'm going to rotate that round so the slot lines up with the pin here. Simply insert it like so. So we're going to insert that into there, and I just pull back slightly on that.
Oh, look at that.
I'm ready to go. Okay, so that's super simple. I just now need to remove that bar back down. That bar needs to come back again when I actually take the head and put it back in there.
Otherwise, you'll be there all day trying to crimp that down.
Experience suggests so. Okay, so I'm now set up and I'm ready to challenge you with your first legacy tool.
Before we do that, just show us how you change it back into the cassette to another one. So let's have the ferrule crimper next, Gary.
Okay, so we're going to go again. We're going to reverse the process. We're going to move this bar up into the up position like so. So lock it into position there. We're going to come back. I've got it lined up again. Just simply put it into position like so. And you should just be able to pull it straight back out.
Like magic.
Fantastic. I'm so pleased that worked as well. Okay, so that's that. And you want to now go for a ferrule crimper?
Yeah, go for the ferrule crimper.
Okay, so you're going to take you on with the ferrule crimper. So it's going to be this one here.
That's the one there.
Yeah, so I'm going to rotate it around like before. Okay, I've already got my bar in position, so I'm in a good place. I'm going to position it in like so. Just going to pull that back slightly.
Oh, he's done it again.
Yep, we can just let me have a moment there. Okay, that's a win. So I'm now the ability to crimp up to 6mm in ferrules. What's your crimping tool going to
do? This will only do 4mm, but I tell you what, should we bring the camera in and have a closer look at how we do this?
We can. I'm loving it. So let's see if the Knipex Multicrimping tool can replace your three legacy tools by, first of all, using this through crimp to join this 1.5mm squared cable together. What do you call those, Gordon?
Well, I'll call them butt crimps, Gary. I believe some of our American viewers might call them splice crimps.
I think you can go first, yeah. So let's join these cables together. So you can go on the 1.5 cable.
So I use my Pressman tool that I've had for a very long time.
Well, you've been on the planet a very long time, so that makes logical sense.
I'll put that in there.
So squeeze that one up.
So the good thing about this tool is you don't need to swap sides to bring the cable in. You can bring it in from either side of the crimping die.
Okay, so you'll see that slight difference on my one. So squeeze that one up then. Okay, and we've used a through crimp.
Through crimp. And the good thing about this tool is it actually stamps the size of the crimp into there itself. So.
Oh yeah, it says 1.5. I like that.
Yeah, so you give that a pull test, guy.
Okay, yep, that's nice and tight.
Like that?
Yeah, I like that a lot.
Key ring, if anyone wants it.
Okay.
Top tip.
Yeah, so I'm now going to obviously put the right one from what you call the cassette into my Knipex crimping tool. So I'm going to choose this one here. So just rotate round so the slot is in the right position to remove this one. Open it out fully, put the bar into position and close it down. And then it's just a simple case of sliding it into position back. And I'm ready to go.
Okay, so I noticed the crimp dies are in a different size to what properly used to. They're not in size order. The yellow pops in the middle. That's caught a few people out.
Yeah, so what we've got there is 1 to 1.5 on the red, 4 to 6 on yellow, and 2.5 on the blue, but not necessarily in that logical sequence. However, it's important that you look at the colours, and for me, I have to bring the cable in from the coloured dot side, because on this side, there are no coloured dots, and it's important I come in from the right side, so I'm going to end up rotating one where you didn't on your Pressman.
Yeah, and we see that's different. Every tool is almost different, the ones we've looked at. We've got an economy-based tool we've looked at in another video. Watch out for that.
Yeah, so now we've got to make sure we remove this bar, open out our ratchet and crimp, and now obviously we're ready to go. Obviously, if we left the bar in, it would be completely impossible. It'd be a long time there. So again, making sure I'm coming in, there's the dot. So I'm going to position the cable in from the side of the dot. Make sure I'm fully inserted like so. So I get it in there. And then I'm just going to crush that one up. Okay, so that's the first one. Rotate myself round into there like so. and then we're going to do the same again. But now, Gordon, I've got to remember that I've got the cable coming in from this side, so my dot needs to be on the same size as the cable.
Okay, so I've noticed you twist your cables before putting them in, Gary. That's a controversial one, so we'll throw that one out there. Do you twist your cable before you put them in the crimp or not?
Okay, so I've got mine nice and tight as well. Okay, so I can't pull those out. Okay, I think what we'll end up doing is, I think there's a video improving how much weight a through crimp can actually withstand. I think that's worth checking that one out, Gordon,
yeah,
don't you?
Watch for that.
Yeah, we had a bit of fun in the gym. Okay, so that's my through crimp. You've done a through crimp, okay? So you've now got to change tools.
Yeah, well,
in order to do a ferrule next.
It's quite easy, Gary. I just move my hand along the table and pick up a crimp tool. So this is my Weidmuller PZ4. That is rock solid, built like a tank. This will do from 0.5 to 4 millimeter cross-section conductors.
Okay, and we're going to be using 1.5 stranded.
Yeah, 1.5 stranded. So it's dead easy. If you haven't seen our video on ferrules, check them out. Dead easy. There we go.
So you had to find that in your toolbox, had to locate where you'd left it and all the rest of it. I've just got to go back to my original Knipex tool here.
Okay, change the head.
It's really, really difficult. So what I've got to do now is I've got to obviously just gently put the bar back into position like so. And then I've got to just put it back in here and just push it into position and then just pull it back out. There we go, so that one's out. And then I just select the next one that I need. So I'm going to have a look around here. I'm going to need this one here. Rotate round to the right position. I've still got my bar in place. Slide it into there, pull back, and I'm ready to go.
Well, well. So I know it's obviously the difference on yours. You've got to select the slot for the right sized ferrule that you're using.
I won't find it difficult because they're labelled 0.25 all the way up to 6mm, and we're going to be doing the 1.5. So take my ferrule, slide it onto there, and then just simply remove the bar, get the ratcheting mechanism open so we know we're ratcheting, find the appropriate hole, and it is just there, and I'm going to just crimp that one up into position like so. Okay, here we go. Yeah, wasn't very difficult, was it? And that won't come off either. So there you go. So I've got two tools in one here. You've had to fumble around in your toolbox to find your second tool, and they're of different makes, and some people get bothered by that. But I've got a small confession now to make, just from the point of view is that I bought the, what you call the cassette with the three in. I actually thought I'd click the one with all five in. My one's missing.
So you're
to do
missing.
The, yes.
So you can't do the what we're going to do now, the copper tube terminal.
No. But you can if you'd have got the correct cassette. So if I'd have got the five-way one, I would have been able to continue on. So that was actually my fault. It's not that I don't do it.
Yeah, and the good thing on the five-way one, actually, the other missing slot in there would be a ferrule crimper that goes all the way up to 25 millimetres squared, which is quite rare in, obviously, in one tool.
Yeah, and I'd argue that would, if I'd have got the right one, I would be taking you apart at this stage.
And the one we haven't featured is the uninsulated crimp, which is these without the insulation on, which I'd suggest quite rare that an electrician would come across those. But yeah, so perhaps Knipex take some advice, ditch that one and put the copper tube one in the three set, okay. So Gary doesn't make any more mistakes. So I'll just do what you can't do, Gary. Yeah. I'll get this copper tube one.
I can do it, I just didn't get the right set. This should be fun because I've seen you do this off camera and this takes a few ounces
of
energy.
So I would suggest this is an economy based copper tube crimper. If you've got any hints and tips on a great tool that I could put in my toolbox that's of the quality of these, or perhaps the Knipex one, we'll go there.
Here we go. This should be fun. Come on then. Come on. You made that look so difficult.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we know that's on.
It's not coming off. And perhaps in another video you can show us the Knipex one.
Yeah, perhaps I can. So, apart from the fact that I apologise I ordered the wrong one, I like the fact that I've got all of that in one set. I love the way it removes the actual crimping tool and puts it back in the cassette. Okay. I really like that. But I know you're quite attached to your legacy
tools. Well, I've had them for a long time. They're good friends. But let's have a look at a weigh-in to see what their weights in would be. Say we're going to check a cheap Ryanair flight somewhere and we need to take the tool back.
Okay, let's get the scales out and see how much you're going to timber up to. So you got the scales out, so let's see how much your three legacy tools weigh.
Okay, the big weigh-in.
Here we go.
I think that's just short of 1.6 kilos, Gary.
Okay, that's fine. So the argument now is going to be is that my three here can't do the same as your three, and I'd have to obviously put the other two in here. Mm-hmm. But my return argument is if I put the other two in there, you'd have to put two more tools on. So I think we'll call that a draw, yes?
Okay. And let's start. Okay, we don't often talk about price directly on the channel, but I'd suggest the price of this is significantly less than three quality tools, and that obviously you can always buy a cheap tool in any variant, then yeah, that's different. So this is weighed in at just about half of that, Gary. Okay. So yeah, so there is a significant weight saving.
Yeah, and like we said, if you're doing international travel or, you know, you're lugging your tools around a site, you know, the benefit of having less weight. And what I really, really like about it is just that ability to have that lovely in and out of the cassette when we're putting them in and out in order that we can keep them.
Yeah, showing off.
Oh, yeah, showing off.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, I would say, obviously, if all you do is ferrule work, buy a ferrule crimper. If all you work on is insulated crimpers, buy an insulated crimp. But if you work in maintenance, repair and operations and you're faced with a deluge of different types of crimps on a daily basis, or you're an occasional crimper and you don't know what you're going to be faced with, then yeah, that's a great option and quality tool, significantly priced, better than multiple quality tools.
So as always, we love to hear your feedback on your crimping tool, your preferred crimping tool, or your preferred set of crimpers. Please make sure you leave those comments below, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.